Happy New Year and welcome to the Mount Prospect Ice Arena here in Mount Prospect, Illinois for tonight's Chicago Catholic Hockey League matchup between the Notre Dame Dons and the Marmion Academy Cadets. My name is Aaron Schellen, and I will be bringing you all the live varsity action this evening. This is the Dons' first game of the 2020 season. They ended 2019 on a bit of a down note as they dropped a 9-1 decision to the hands of Providence Catholic back on 12-13. So they're looking for a much better outcome and a much better effort tonight against the Cadets. We're about a minute and a half away from puck drop here, so let's take a quick look at the CCHL standings. Marmion Academy currently sits seventh in the CCHL with a 4-8 record on the year, while Notre Dame sits in the cellar at 1-12-1. So a difficult season for a young and inexperienced Notre Dame club, although there have been some improvements over the course of the year. There have been some players who have stood out, players like Anthony Esposito, who leads the team with a couple of goals and three assists. Ryan Sheehan, who leads the team in goal scoring with four goals. And Andreas Zorn, the leader of this club, three goals and one assist for 4 points. So there have been some pretty solid individual efforts, not to mention the play of goaltender Mike Miskovich, who numbers don't really bear out how solid he's been in goal for the Dons this year. He has a 4.46 goals against average, but a save percentage approaching 90, which if you do the math, tells you that this Dons team tends to get outshot pretty regularly. So Michael does a fantastic job of keeping them in these ball games. So we're getting ready here again for the puck drop and other Notre Dame Dons action. The JV squad took on Marist last night and dropped a 3-0 decision there. So JV team struggling a little bit this year as well, but a lot of young talent on that club as well that hopefully we'll see some ice time starting next year for the big club. So as I mentioned, very young, very inexperienced team. So future is a little bit brighter than the present for this Notre Dame club. Trying to get a starting goaltender here for you for Marmion Academy as soon as I can. They've got three goaltenders on their roster. They were led out onto the ice by Christopher Mazurek, so I would assume he will be the starting goalie this evening. He is 2-3 on the year with a 4.28 goals against average, an .898 save percentage with a shutout. Actually, it looks like it might be... Yeah, it looks like it's actually going to be Beckham Dempsey, who is making only his third start of the year. He's 0-2 with a 5.5 goals against and a save percentage of .886. So again, Marmion came out with three goalies on their roster and had to wait to see which one was going to stand in goal before I could let you know. You are watching Notre Dame Dons Hockey tonight on Facebook Live, powered by the Illinois Media School. My team tonight is Timmy Helms running the board, Eric Willowhite on camera, and we are about ready to bring you some hockey action. Out on the ice for the Dons is Andreas Zorn, Jeremy Langbein, and Liam McGiernan. Faceoff is won by Marmion. Puck is cleared up to Galley. Galley gets the puck across over to Samuel Greco, and the puck is cleared down in deep there, fired around, kept in by the Cadets, but then Zorn is able to bat it up ahead to Langbein, 2-on-1, Langbein and McKiernan. McKiernan has it, shot, score! Liam McKiernan with his second goal of the game, and just like that, 25 seconds into the game, the Dons lead it 1-2-0. Beautiful pass off the stick of Jeremy Langbein, tape to tape to Liam McKiernan. McKiernan roofs it, and the Dons take an early 1-0 lead. It's the start you want if you are this Notre Dame club. Get out on the board early here. Leo Psycho dumps it back into his own zone. Spencer Reiske has it. tries to play it up out of the zone. He's unable to. Dons have it, and they're able to clear it out into center ice. Puck is dumped back into the Notre Dame zone. Gill goes back on it, plays it behind his own net, up around to Georges. Georges is unable to keep it in. It's thrown back in deep by Dylan Foster all the way around. And not out, and then it is finally batted out into center ice. And Evanoff will take over there for the Dons as Marmion has to clear the zone. Puck cleared back into the cadet zone. Cross-ice pass is intercepted there by Notre Dame. McGiernan, he of the goal scorer, dumps it down in deep behind Dempsey. Zorn is able to play it and keep it in. It's fired up and under the stick of Scotty Slechter and out. Puck is steered to the corner by Miskovich. Andreas Zorn picks it up now for the Dons. Langbein tips it, leaves it for McGiernan. McGiernan throws it on the backhand looking for Langbein, and that pass is intercepted and taken down now by Andrew Galley. Galley leaves it shot on Miskovich. Miskovich is able to make the save, and the puck is cleared out there. Galley with it now for the Cadets. Matthew Sitar skates it out into center ice. He has a stick lifted by Jeremy Langbein, and the puck is dumped back into the Marmion zone. Langbein on the forecheck for Notre Dame. Andreas Zorn intercepts the clearing pass, and we're going to have a penalty called here on Notre Dame. It looks like they're going to get Zorn for a hook or an interference or something of that nature. As Dempsey goes back to his bench, Zorn played the puck. I'm not sure why the whistle didn't blow there. Langbein's going to touch up, and we still don't have a whistle. Marmion is able to get the puck into the zone. Pichetti has it, leaves it for Galley. Galley centers it. Beautiful leg pad save by Miskovich. Notre Dame finally touches up. There's our whistle, and we will have a penalty called here. Let's see who goes to the box. I believe they got Andreas Zorn. Yep, Zorn goes to the penalty box for hooking. So with 14:11 left to go here in the first period, the Dons lead Marmion 2-1. Marmion will go on their first power play of the game. Face off to the left of Miskovich. Scrum to the left of the cage. Notre Dame's able to clear it up, but not out. And it's dumped around deep where Nowicki goes after it for Marmion. It's cleared back to the point. Over to Heath Powers. Powers gets it over to Foster, who dumps it down deep. Backhanded out into the crease. It's cleared away, and Evanoff tries to get it up on the backhand. He can't, and it's cleared back behind Mike Miskovich. Puck in the near corner now. Heath Powers with the shot from the point, deflected over Miskovich and up against the back glass. Marmion has it behind the net. Puck is deflected into the corner there by the Dons. Izagiri goes after it with Tommy Schrantz. Back to the point to Powers. Powers fakes the shot. He's got Tommy Schrantz on him. Powers misplays the puck. Marmion's able to keep it in there. Back to the point to Blake Powers. Powers with the shot on, and Miskovich is able to make the body save. He covers up, and we will have a faceoff. 13:12 left to go in period number one. Notre Dame leads 1-0 on a goal 25 seconds into the game off the stick of Liam McGiernan on a beautiful feed from Jeremy Langbein on a 2-on-1, giving Notre Dame an early lead. Faceoff to the right of Miskovich. Won by Notre Dame and cleared all the way down. Winning that faceoff is critical when you're a man down in your own zone. Get control of the puck, get it out, and force Marmion to go the length of the ice. Puck is cleared into the zone by Henry Walton, team's leading goal scorer with 5, but he got in ahead of the play, and we will have offside. So Liam McKiernan will take over now for the Dons. He's got plenty of time and scales it down all the way on Dempsey, who has to make the save. 30 seconds left on the Marmion power play. Hit at center ice by McKiernan. Brought in now by Greco. Greco throws it on goal, and that one gets through Miskovich, but he's able to cover that one up before it crosses the goal line for the faceoff. Samuel Greco, the Marmion leading scorer with 7 points this year, came down on the near side, threw the puck on Miskovic. It got through him, but he was able to cover up with his glove for a faceoff. 21 seconds left on the man advantage for Marmion Academy. Faceoff is fought for at the faceoff dot. Won nicely by McKiernan, and he throws it down the length of the ice. Liam McKiernan's had himself a really nice first 5 or 6 minutes here for Notre Dame. Andrew Galley skates up through center ice, goes around a Notre Dame defender, tries to leave it for somebody. There's nobody there. It gets down on Miskovic, gets through Miskovic, and then taken over by Notre Dame. Langbein comes up. Penalty is up. Langbein throws it down on goaltender Beckham Dempsey, who has to cover up for the whistle. Not a bad idea there by Langbein. You throw the puck down on goal, and maybe you get a funny bounce. Maybe Dempsey allows a rebound, and you never know what's going to happen. But the faceoff will come to Dempsey's left. Anthony Esposito on the draw for Notre Dame. Puck is cleared around, and Marmion will take it out there. Up across into center ice into the Notre Dame zone. Puck is thrown and tipped out of the zone by Leo Psycho, and Heath Powers will have to go back and take that one for the Cadets. Backhanded pass attempted for Mark Pichetti is intercepted by the Dons. And the Cadets have it again. They lose it to Izagiri, who clears it back out into center ice. Played at the red line. Esposito goes back for it with Powers. Powers skates onto it for Marmion. Throws it up into center ice. Nobody home, and the Dons are there to collect it at center ice. Izagiri skates it across the logo, loses control of it, and it's brought right back in by Blake Powers. Powers' shot on Miskovic is deflected into the corner. Two men to a side in the far corner behind goaltender Miskovic. Puck is pinned against that far glass. Finally dug out by the Dons. Rides along the dasher. Thrown on Miskovic. It goes wide. Taken over by Notre Dame. Cleared up off the near boards, but not out. Matthew Sitar throws it. Another left pad save by Miskovic as he clears that one into the corner. And Leo Psycho skates out onto it. He loses it. And the puck is thrown back in by Marmion, but taken over by Notre Dame. Gill gets it up to Sheehan. He loses control of the puck. Here comes Andrew Galley. Galley on the backhand. Right pad save by Miskovic. He runs into Miskovic. And we're going to have a whistle. I think the net came off the moorings there. But a couple of nice saves by Miskovic here early on. Couple of really nice left leg pad saves. And he's controlling those rebounds, putting them where he wants to go in the corner. So, yeah, we had the net come off its mooring, so the faceoff is going to come in the Notre Dame zone to the right of Miskovic. 10:17 left to go in period number one, 1-0 in Notre Dame on an early goal by Liam McKiernan. Sheehan skates onto it for Notre Dame. He comes down the near side with some speed. Wrist shot on, juicy rebound by Dempsey. It's taken over by Marmion. Galley skates onto it, but then Reiske takes it away from him. Sheehan plays it. He's knocked down, but Max Evanoff takes it, skates it up into some space, throws it into the center. There's nobody there, and we're going to have a penalty called on Marmion, and Notre Dame will go on the power play. It's going to be an interference call on Samuel Greco. Faceoff is going to, should be in the Marmion zone. Not sure why they're standing at center ice, but we're going to have McKiernan, Zorn, Langbein, Reiske, and Anthony Esposito. They run with four forwards on their power play. I forgot about that. So they run with Andreas Zorn and Spencer Reiske on the point with McKiernan, Esposito, and Langbein, the forwards for the Dons. Reiske over to Zorn. They give him the space, and then he's knocked down as he clears the puck in. Takes the body to make the play. Back to Zorn at the point. The puck is deflected into the corner. Langbein has it there. Back to Zorn at the point. Zorn back down to Langbein. Langbein loses it. It's cleared up but not out, and then eventually flipped out into center ice, and Reiske goes after it with Galley. Galley has it. Galley skates it into the corner. Nice defensive play by Spencer Reiske to take the puck away from Galley. Reiske tries to hit McKiernan up ahead, and that will be icing. The puck just out of reach of Liam McKiernan, and the faceoff will come down in the Notre Dame zone with a minute 24 left to go on the Dons power play. They lead 1-0 here on a goal 25 seconds into the game off the stick of Liam McKiernan on a nice feed from Jeremy Langbein on a 2-on-1. McKiernan was able to roof it glove side, giving the Dons an early lead. Andreas Zorn, the captain, skates out for it, drops it back for Langbein. Langbein up ahead to McKiernan. McKiernan, with some space on the far side, skates it across the blue line on the backhand. He's got some space, gets it over to Zorn. Zorn back at the point, back to McKiernan. Loses control of the puck there for a second. Puck is cleared up, and it clears the zone, so Notre Dame will have to tag up. Gets all the way around. Nobody touches it. Jeremy Langbein is able to skate on it there. McKiernan comes down 1-on-3 now in the slot. McKiernan shot, score! Liam McKiernan picks up the loose puck, skates into the slot, shoots it stick side high, giving Notre Dame a 2-0 lead. You can see here McKiernan is able to jump on the puck at the blue line, skates it in between the dots, and fires off a bullet into that top corner, giving the Dons a 2-0 lead here with 8:36 left to go. Faceoff won by Marmion as Notre Dame has jumped out to an early 2-0 lead here on a pair of goals by Liam McKiernan. Came into the game with one goal on the season. He's got two tonight. Puck is cleared around, but not out. All the way down on Miskovic, and the puck is cleared out into center ice. Dylan Foster takes over for Marmion. Puck is deflected all the way down by Miskovic. Scotty Slechter will pick it up there for the Dons. Goes back behind himself, picks the puck up on the backhand, skates it out into center ice, and dumps it down deep, and he goes after it now. Slechter all the way down behind goaltender Beckham Dempsey. Panico has it now. Panico and Slechter are battling for it for the Dons, and the puck is caught up on the netting, and I think we're going to have another penalty called here. I think we're going to have a slashing penalty called on... Penalty called here on Blake Powers. A two-minute penalty for slashing. And Notre Dame goes right back on the power play. They're up 2-0 here. Pair of goals off the stick of Liam McKiernan. Faceoff won by Esposito. Back to Reiske at the point. Reiske over to McKiernan. Back to Reiske. Reiske plays with the puck down to Langbein. Langbein to McKiernan behind the net. Back to Zorn at the point. Deflected just wide. Puck is cleared out into center ice, and Zorn will have to play it for the Dons in his own zone. Nice attempt there by Zorn and Langbein. That tip by Langbein went just high, but that was well executed by the Dons. Puck fired around deep behind Beckham Dempsey, who stops it there, plays it into the near corner to Dylan Foster, and Foster's able to clear it up and out. Stopped by Miskevich. And Reiske skates out now with some speed into the Marmion zone. Reiske down back behind the net. Leaves it for McKiernan. The puck is down on goaltender, and it's cleared back to the point, but Reiske has it for the Dons. McKiernan now in the far corner for Notre Dame. Skates behind the net, comes up the near side, stops on the half boards, and dumps it down in for Anthony Esposito behind the net. Esposito on the backhand. Back to Reiske at the point. Reiske with the wrist shot that's deflected up into the netting, and we will have a faceoff. 6:26 left to go in the first period. 37 seconds left on the man advantage for the Dons. They lead this one 2-0 on a pair of goals by Liam McKiernan, who came into tonight with only one goal in 11 games. Well, he's now got 3 goals in 12 games. So Liam McKiernan is having himself a period here for Notre Dame. Faceoff won by the Dons. Evanoff has it back to the point. Evanoff gets it back to skates out, switches places with Schlechter. Schlechter's able to dump that one down deep. Tommy Schrantz has it back over, tries to play it over to Schlechter, and the puck is deflected there by Marmion, backhanded up but not out. Sheehan throws it back down deep, and it's taken over by Dylan Foster. Foster clears it up but not out. Schlechter's able to keep it in for a second, and Evanoff throws it down deep for Sheehan. Sheehan's got Schrantz if he looks up, and that's going to do it on the power play. Sheehan back to the point to Schlechter. Schlechter mishits on the one-timer. In fact, his stick blows up, and Marmion skates down with the man advantage. Sheehan takes over there nicely, though, and is able to clear it up and out. Schlechter tried to tee up the one-timer, and his stick exploded on him. Pichetti leaves it for Powers. That's Samuel Greco. We're going to have a penalty called here on Notre Dame. It's kept in by Matthew Sitar. Sitar gets it down into the corner. Back to Sitar at the point. Cross ice pass to Pichetti. Goes under his stick into the corner. And Notre Dame is able to touch up, and that will create a stoppage of play with 5:03 left to go in period number one. Notre Dame leads 2-0. And I have a penalty called here on Anthony Esposito. 2 minutes for hooking is the call. So Marmion will go on their second power play of the game. Notre Dame was able to effectively kill off the first one. Sitar has the puck at the point now for Marmion. Down to Walton. Walton here on the half boards. Over to Sitar at the point. Backhanded attempt is deflected behind the goal. Samuel Greco has it in the near corner. Bad angle shot is deflected behind the net. Greco's hit there by Izaguirre. Back out to the point. Shot deflected just wide. Had a wide open net there and wasn't able to deflect that one home. Miskovic got a little lucky there. Shot on Miskovic is sticked into the corner. Notre Dame's not able to clear it out, though, as McKiernan goes after it. Kept in by Marmion. Getting some ice time here. Cross ice pass. Back to the point to Walton. Walton shot, score. Notre Dame had a couple of opportunities to clear the puck on that power play. They were not able to. Walton shot from the point, beats Miskovic, and it is 2-1 Notre Dame. 4:05 left to go here in period number one. Face-off at center ice. Sheehan, Evanoff, and Schrantz are out there for face-off at center ice. Puck is cleared down, and that will not be icing as it was touched by a Marmion player there. Keith Powers plays it around for the Cadets. The puck is cleared up into center ice and out, and skating on it is Nowicki. Nowicki comes down on Landvitt. Puck is thrown on goal, and Miskovic is able to make the save. Schrantz has it now. Landvitt takes over behind his own net. Landvitt skates out into center ice, and he's able to dump it into the zone momentarily, but that is offsides. Notre Dame will have to touch up. Puck is cleared into the Notre Dame zone. Schlechter has it gently up ice. Sheehan gets it up ahead to Schrantz. Schrantz comes down one on two. Schrantz with the fake, skates around, goes bad angle. Nice shot, nice pad save by Beckham Dempsey there to deflect that one into the corner. Schlechter has it up into center ice to McKiernan. Liam McKiernan comes down in between the slots. Has the puck now behind Dempsey. Gretzky's office in the slot to Zorn. The puck is deflected. Izaguirre takes over. Shot goes just wide. Kept in by McKiernan. McKiernan with another shot that goes, that one went headhunting on Beckham Dempsey, and Dempsey ducked out of the way, and the puck went over the net. Izaguirre comes down with some speed now. Nolan Izaguirre, shot, bad angle, almost gets through Dempsey. Dempsey looks behind him, but that one was covered up, and we will have a faceoff with 2:32 left to go in the period. 2-1 is the score. A couple of goals by Liam McKiernan gave Notre Dame an early 2-0 lead. Henry Walton has scored one to bring the game within one at 2-1 here. Faceoff to the right of Dempsey. 2.5 minutes left to go in the first period. Samuel Greco takes over from Army, and he comes flying down ice. And that one is going to be offsides. He came down with some speed, and he cut along the blue line, and his line mates were forced to stop, and they weren't able to. Brady Gill with it now for the Dons. Puck is cleared up into center ice. Marmion takes it right back, and Galley comes back. Shot on Miskovic. Miskovic, with some self-defense there, is able to glove that one down as that one was going right for the old noggin, but he was able to secure it for the save. 2:02 left to go in this one. Faceoff in the first period here. Faceoff's going to come to the right of Miskovic in the Notre Dame zone. Shots on goal are 13-10 in favor of Marmion. Puck in the corner cleared out into the slot. Nobody home. Leo Psycho takes over for the Dons, and he'll skate onto it. Gets it over to Max Evanoff. Evanoff skates across the line. Shot goes on goaltender Beckham Dempsey. Dempsey's able to make the save. He looked a little unsure of himself with that one. So if you're the Dons, I think that the message here is just keep shooting, keep getting the puck on net, as Dempsey has looked a little shaky here early on. Let up a couple of goals, had one that he thought went through him, and then that one there he didn't look all that comfortable with. Shot through the crease by Georges, goes all the way through and will be taken over by Nowicki. Nowicki comes down in the far corner. Gill with the big hit in the corner. Nice hit by Brady Gill. Puck is deflected but not out, kept in by Heath Powers. Powers centers it. There's nobody there, and Gill is able to backhand that one out with a minute 22 left to go in the first period of a 2-1 ball game. Georges on the forecheck for Notre Dame. Heath Powers has it now, gets it back to his D partner. Back up to Powers. Powers backhands it up into center ice where Pichetti has it. Leaves it for Blake Powers, and the puck is stolen away by Andreas Zorn. Zorn absorbs the contact, dumps the puck in deep, and Marmion will take over there. Heath Powers behind his own net, throws it up into center ice. Nobody home. Spencer Reiske takes over for the Dons. Up but not out, kept in by Marmion. Puck is centered. Miskovic is able to kick that one out, and Esposito plays it for the Dons, and the puck is thrown right back in. Zorn has it. Andreas Zorn clears it up, out into center ice, down as far as the blue line where Matthew Sitar takes over. Sitar has it now with Langbein bearing down on him on the forecheck. McKiernan goes that. Liam McKiernan gets that one, but it's deflected. Langbein has it. Langbein shot, saved by Dempsey. Puck is thrown down, and that will be an icing. With 5.8 seconds left to go, good opportunity there by Jeremy Langbein. Was able to steal a loose puck and kind of swing around and get a shot on Dempsey. And Dempsey was able to get that left pad out, kick it into the corner. No harm done. 5.8 seconds left to go. Opportunity here for the Dons to get one more shot. Zorn wins it back to McKiernan. McKiernan's shot goes just by the near post, and that will do it. Liam McKiernan was looking for the Hattie in the first period. That one did not miss the post by very much. And at the end of one period, the score is Notre Dame 2, Marmion 1. You're watching Notre Dame Dons Hockey on Facebook Live, powered by the Illinois Media School. And we'll be back with second period action right after this. And we are back. Second period about to get underway here with the Dons leading the Marmion Academy Cadets 2-0. Notre Dame got on the board 25 seconds into the game on a goal by Liam McKiernan on a beautiful feed by Jeremy Langbein on a 2-on-1. Notre Dame extended their lead on the power play off the stick of that man again, Liam McKiernan, to make it 2-0. And then Henry Walton scored a power play goal of his own, making the score 2-1 Notre Dame as we get ready to start second period action here. Marmion in their white uniforms with the blue numbers and red lettering. Notre Dame in their home blues with white and green piping and their white numbers. And they actually, for the first time a couple weeks ago, they unveiled their third jerseys. Very, very sharp. Hope to see those again before the end of the season. They're all green jerseys with the ND logo on the front. Very sharp. Hope to be able to call a game with one of those before the end of the season. Faceoff is won briefly by Notre Dame, but Marmion has it now. Max Evanoff fighting in the corner for it. And Blake Powers takes over for the Cadets. Sheehan throws his big body in there, and he's able to dump it back down in deep where Dylan Foster has it, clears it up, but not out. Scotty Slechter plays it nicely. Slechter with the wrist shot goes high and wide. You can tell Notre Dame's here. The book on Beckham Dempsey for Notre Dame is to shoot that puck high. Both of their goals were on high wrist shots. And on more than one instance, the Dons have been trying to go upstairs on Beckham Dempsey, and that was no exception as Scotty Slechter shot that one over the net. And we will have an icing here. 16-17 just underway here in period number two. Faceoff to the left of Dempsey. Andreas Zorn on the draw for the Dons. Puck is cleared up into center ice. Skated on there by Galley. Miskovic comes out to play that one as Galley was almost in all alone. McKiernan comes down now across the blue line, leaves it for Zorn. Zorn throws it on goal, and Dempsey's able to make the save. Cleared up and down into the Notre Dame zone, and Nolan Izaguirre will play it for the Dons. Leaves it for McKiernan. McKiernan along the boards, stops on a dime. Turns around, gets it up to Zorn. Zorn plays it between his skates. The puck is kept in. Shot deflected on Miskovic. Miskovic makes the reflective save, and the puck is cleared down into the Marmion zone. Zorn has it, but Langbein was offside, so Zorn just has to clear it in. Andreas Zorn on the forecheck. Puck is cleared up into center ice, and Anthony Esposito takes over for the Dons. On the backhand, throws it down in deep. And Leo Psycho goes down on the forecheck. Puck is fired around, up and out, but Esposito has it, plays it back to Gill. Gill plays it underneath Esposito, and it's stolen there by Walton. Marmion skates back into their own zone, resets the offense. Up to Michael Greco. Greco does a spinorama and gets it over to his D partner, Matthew Sitar. Sitar skates up on it. Gets it into center ice. It's thrown cross ice. Brady Gill will play that one for the Dons, however, behind his own net. Puck is kept in momentarily, and Esposito takes it, loses it, gets it over to Psycho, and Georges has it now, and then Georges loses it. Brady Gill skates onto it at center ice. Gill with the wrist shot that's deflected up and over the net. Esposito on the forecheck. Psycho plays it. It's in his skates. He doesn't know where it is. Puck is kept in by Slechter nicely. Back to Psycho. Psycho loses the puck. Slechter's able to keep it in again and hammer it around to the far corner where Matthew Panico plays that one. Panico's chopped down there. Psycho has it. Puck is cleared back to the point. Splits the D pairing. And that will come all the way down to goaltender Miskovic, who stops it there for Scotty Slechter. Slechter skates onto it behind his own net. Up to Panico, gets through Panico. Puck comes to a stop at the red line, and Marmion will skate onto it there. Panico loses it, but Zorn is there to clean it up, and then Andreas Zorn loses it, and it's skated back on by Nowicki, who shoots it on Miskovic, and Miskovic makes a nice blocker save. Andreas Zorn on the far boards, tries to clear it out, he can't. He's double-teamed down there, back to the point to Sitar. Sitar's shot on Miskovic is pitchforked into the corner by the Dons goaltender. Andreas Zorn skates out now, possible break here. Andreas Zorn with the shot on Dempsey. Dempsey makes the save there. Nice play by Andreas Zorn. He saw that he wasn't going to have his support coming down the far side. So before the D closed on him, he got that low wrist shot off, forcing Dempsey to make the save. 13-12 left to go in the middle frame here. 2-1, Notre Dame leads Marmion. 16-14, the Cadets lead shots on goal. Puck is cleared up and out. And this one's going to catch the red line, and that will be icing. Unsure for a second if that one was going to make it all the way down, but it had just enough. We will have another faceoff to the right of Beckham Dempsey. Our next broadcast will actually be a doubleheader right back here next Sunday as we do both the varsity and the JV games. So stick around for that. Those games will both be on sportstownchicago.com, powered by the Illinois Media School. So come watch some hockey. Come hang out down here with us at the Mount Prospect Ice Arena. You can watch us on sportstownchicago.com. Love to have you here with us. Face off to the left now of Beckham Dempsey. Tommy Schrantz will take the draw for the Dons. He wins it back to Sheehan. Sheehan back to Landvid at the point. The puck is deflected wide of Dempsey. Backhanded up. Evanoff tries to keep it in. Reiske's able to keep it back in and clear it back down around. Sheehan goes after it in the far corner. Ryan Sheehan, the puck is then cleared around by Marmion up into center ice. And Landvit is skates onto it, but then has it taken away from him by Mark Pichetti. Pichetti skates across the blue line. Pichetti in on the backhand. That one's deflected wide. Marmion still has it, though. Blake Powers is able to clear it in. Miskovich plays it up around, and Sheehan clears it to the point, but not out. Shot back down is wide. Landvit throws it up to the point. Puck is blocked into the corner by Miskovich. Again, that shot is deflected, and Notre Dame skates onto it now up into center ice. Schrantz has it, goes around, tries to go around Dylan Foster, but he's unable to. Foster's a big boy down there for Marmion. Selector tries to keep it in. He's not able to, but Notre Dame is able to recover the puck for a moment. Liam McKiernan comes down now 3-on-2 for the Dons. Liam McKiernan with some speed, looking for somebody to get it to. Has to just dump it back along the dasher. Notre Dame's able to keep it in, though. Brady Gill on it. Puck is cleared up but not out. Schrantz throws it down into the near corner. And Langbein has it and just clears it down deeper. Langbein on the half boards. Throws it back behind Beckham Dempsey. A couple players go head over skates in the corner. Langbein on it for Notre Dame, and Marmion's Andrew Galley will skate up onto it into center ice, up ahead to Samuel Greco. Greco with the shot, and Miskovich tries to make the save. The puck slips through his glove, goes right through the paint, and fortunate for the Dons, stays out of the goal. Puck is fought for at center ice, and Marmion will skate on it there. Shot, pass from Walton is deflected wide, and we will have a penalty called here on Notre Dame for hooking. Looks like Scott Selector is going to go for this one, and we are 10:33 left to go here in the second period. The Dons lead the Cadets by the score of 2-1. Marmion is 1-for-2 on the power play so far tonight. Going to get another opportunity here to tie the game. Their last goal was scored by Henry Walton. That was his sixth goal of the season. Actually, that penalty's on Liam McKiernan for hooking, not Selector. Puck is kept in by Marmion. Galley has it at the point. Over to Sitar. Down on the near board, or far boards, to Blake Powers. Powers has the puck at the point. Over to Galley. Galley back to Sitar. Sitar over to Powers, back to Sitar. Shot on Miskovich, and Miskovich is able to make the right pad, right glove save and cover up with a minute 32 left to go. 10:05 left to go in the second period. The Dons still lead 2-1. Faceoff will come to the right of goaltender Miskovich. Andreas Zorn wins the draw, but the Dons aren't able to clear it out. Reiske is able to hammer it up out into center ice, though, for the Dons, and that puck will be played by Andrew Galley behind his goaltender, Beckham Dempsey. Galley skates up through center ice with it for the Cadets, across the Dons' blue line. Skates a circle, looks for somebody to pass it to, gets it back to Sitar at the point. Sitar over to Powers, back to Sitar, down to Galley. Galley cross ice to Powers, down deep, back to Powers, back to Sitar at the point, over to Galley, back to Sitar. Sitar shot from the point. Miskovich is able to make the initial save, and then he covers up for the whistle. 43 seconds left to go on the man advantage for Marmy, and the Dons still lead 2-1 on a pair of goals off the stick of Liam McKiernan in that first period. First one came 25 seconds into the game. Second one came on the power play. Faceoff won by Marmion. Down deep to Samuel Greco, over to Powers on the half boards. Up top to Keith Powers, back to his Blake. Blake with the shot is deflected, doesn't make it in on Miskovich. And Landvitt tries to clear it out, he can't. Pichetti has it, skates out in front of the net. Miskovich makes the save. Another shot, rebound in the puck in the crease, and it's batted in by Dylan Foster, and this game is tied. It's a couple times now Notre Dame has been a man down and had some opportunities to clear the puck out, and they just haven't been able to. And Marmion makes them pay, and we have a brand new game with 8:51 left to go in this one. We are all tied up at 2. For Dylan Foster, that's his second goal of the game, and that was a dirty goal, as they say, you know, kind of grubby down on the crease, just beating at the puck until it found its way across the red line. Marmion comes right back in here on the Dons. Puck is centered, nobody home. Nice defense there by the Dons, and it's skated on by Anthony Esposito. Esposito across the blue line. Esposito stops, shot on. Dempsey goes wide, and it is cleared cross ice. Notre Dame takes over right there. Esposito throws it back in deep, and Georges tries to play the forecheck for Notre Dame. The Dons have it at center ice, thrown right back in, where Dempsey stops it there, misplays it for a second. That got a little hairy for the Cadets, and it's cleared right back in by the Dons. Georges tries to play it, but again, that big body of Foster just stops him in his tracks. 3-on-2 here for Marmion if they hurry. Puck played up to Pichetti. Pichetti's got Sitar with him. Pichetti has it, tries to center it, and Notre Dame comes out with it. Esposito tries to send Georges in, but they're all out of steam. They go for a change, and the puck is cleared down, and Marmion Academy will take over there. Skated on by Matthew Sitar. Feels like he's been out there the entire game. Sitar on the far boards gets checked into the corner by Andreas Zorn. Puck is played around to the near corner to Langbein, who tries to get it up to McKiernan, and they're not able to play it, but McKiernan goes down on it there, is able to play the puck away from Walton. Andreas Zorn has the puck, is batted out up into center ice. So another almost for Liam McKiernan as he tried to skate through a couple defenders. He just wasn't able to complete it. Andrew Galley plays it, but it's deflected back to Sitar. Sitar over to Savarisi. Back to Sitar. Zorn on the forecheck. Around to Michael Greco. Puck is kept in by McKiernan. McKiernan in the slot to Zorn. Zorn loses the puck as he was in the slot. Langbein has it, gets it back to Zorn. Langbein's checked into the corner, plays it deeper. McKiernan on the forecheck, skates off, and Reiske's able to play that one. Drops it for Zorn. Andreas Zorn flips it in to the Marmion zone, where the Cadets will take over there. Langbein on the forecheck. Puck is cleared around, up and across the blue line and out. Greco and Zorn fight for it. Greco wins it down on Miskovich, and we're going to have another penalty called here on Notre Dame for hooking. Who's this? This one is going to be on... Who are they going to get for hooking? You got to send somebody to the box. Looks like Tommy Schrantz is going to go for hooking here. So this Marmion Academy power play, which is 2-for-3 on the game, goes right back out there with an opportunity to take the lead with 6:03 left to go in the second period. This game is all tied at 2. Back to the point to Foster. Foster shot on Miskovich, and Miskovich covers that one up for the draw. Notre Dame got on the board with 2 quick goals in the first period, both off the stick of Liam McKiernan, but a couple of power play goals here by the Cadets, one in the first period, one in here in the second period, has tied this game at 2. Down in the near, in the far boards to Blake Powers, back to the point underneath the stick of Heath Powers, and he has to skate on that one and start over. Evanoff on the forecheck up to Dylan Foster. Foster plays it up to Blake Powers. Powers with the shot deflected wide. McKiernan gets on it first. He tries to play it out. Puck manages to trickle across the blue line. And we're going to have another penalty called here on Notre Dame. McKiernan and Powers ran into each other in center ice. And they're going to call McKiernan for roughing. And Marmion's going to have a 2-man advantage for a minute 20. That's a rough call on Liam McKiernan. And the two of them just ran into each other at center ice. And you can see McKiernan going over the ref to try to plead his case. But to no avail. And Marmion will go up 2 men for a minute 20 here. Coach trying to get an explanation. Regardless, McKiernan in the box for 2 minutes for roughing. Scotty Slechter still in there for another minute 20 as he was called for hooking. And Notre Dame needs another player on the ice. That person will be Isaac Geary as he's out there with Zorn and Reiske to try to kill off this 2-man advantage for the Cadets. Isaac Geary has it behind his own net, has some time, clears it up, but not out. Galley has it. Galley on the far boards down low to Matthew Greco. Greco to Sitar. Sitar gets across ice to Walton. Walton on the far half boards, up top to Sito. Over to Galley, who skates through, gets it down to Walton. Shot is in, and that's what happens when you keep shooting yourself in the foot with penalties. Marmion Academy's come all the way back on 3 power play goals, and they lead the Dons 3-2. Agree or disagree with the calls, you gotta play smart, and Marmion has taken a 3-2 lead here after trailing 2-0 early on. Face-off won by the Dons, cleared as far as center ice, and Galley skates on it for the Cadets. Galley comes down behind Miskovich, comes around the back to the point to Sitar. Sitar down low to Powers. Down to Samuel Greco. Greco back to the point to Sitar. Sitar to Galley. Puck is cleared cross ice. And Walton has it. Walton up to the point to Sitar. Sitar and Walton playing catch at the point. Shot is deflected wide. Powers goes after it. He's hit there by Slechter. Slechter tries to play it with his hand. He can't. Langbein has it, and he's able to clear it up and out for the Dons. 30 seconds left to go on the roughing penalty to Liam McKiernan. 3:50 left to go in the second period. The Dons now trail 3-2. three power play goals here tonight for the Cadets. Matthew Sitar has some trouble with it, but he's able to skate on it. We're down to 12 seconds left in the period, or on the power play, rather. Sheehan on the forecheck is going to kill the rest of that time off. And the penalty kill is up, and the Dons are back to full strength. Henry Walton on the backhand skates. Nice move. Walton throws it cross ice, open net. Easiest goal of the night for Blake Powers. He hit a wide open net, and it's 4-2 Marmion. It's a beautiful individual effort by Henry Walton as he skated back behind Miskovich, was able to get away from the Dons defender who lost his stick, made a nice move back towards the slot. Miskovich overcommitted a little bit, found Powers cross ice, and Powers buried the open netter, and it's 4-2 Marmion. Pichetti has it for the Cadets back behind Miskovich. Shots on goal are now 28-14 for Marmion Academy. It was 16-14 at one time, so second period has been all Cadets. Powers has it now, throws it back to the point to Foster. Foster back to Powers, down to Nowicki. Gill tries to play it. Powers is able to clear it back behind Miskovich, though. Miskovich stops it for Nowicki. Miskovich has to get back in his goal. Pichetti has it, throws it out into the slot, and Notre Dame's able to skate out onto that one. Leo Psycho comes down with Georges. Psycho tries to get the shot off. It's deflected into the corner. Heath Powers has it for the Cadets. Georges on the forecheck. The puck is down into the Notre Dame zone. We're down to 2 minutes left to go in period number two. Esposito up ahead. Shot on. Beckham Dempsey is gloved down by off the stick of Georges, and we'll have a face-off to the left of Dempsey with 2 minutes left to go in the second period. The Dons, what was a very promising start for Notre Dame, has turned into a 4-2 deficit here with 2 minutes left to go in period number two. Notre Dame again a man short on the ice. So Ryan Sheehan hops over the boards. Puck is cleared up as far as center ice and fired back in by Reiske. Michael Greco takes over for Marmion. Puck is chopped at, and Galley hammers that one out into center ice. Slechter on it. Reiske gets it up ahead to center ice, but Marmion is there waiting. Greco plays it up into center ice through to Samuel Greco. Greco throws it cross ice. Reiske breaks that one up nicely. Puck is available in the slot. Marmion has it there. Andrew Galley skates through one defender, two defenders, loses that one, and Reiske skates onto it for the Dons. Puck is flipped into the near corner, where Marmion will backhand it around. Landvitt's able to keep it in momentarily. He gets hit hard up against the boards, and the puck is batted out into center ice, and we will have a penalty called on Marmion. With a minute two left to go here in the second period, it's an opportunity for the Dons to get back into this one. Andrew Galley is going to go to the box for roughing, or for high sticking, rather. So minute two left to go in this one, so if Notre Dame doesn't score, they'll have a man advantage to start the third period. Zorn and Reiske back on the points for Notre Dame. McEernan, Esposito, and Jeremy Langbein out there as the forward line for the Dons. Zorn up into center ice to Esposito. Anthony Esposito skates across the blue line. Puck is cleared back behind Beckham Dempsey. Cleared up, splits the defense, and that one scaled the length of the ice. Miskovich stops it for Zorn. Zorn loses it in his skates. Doesn't know where the puck is. Langbein's able to skate down on it with 35 seconds left. Langbein stops, backtracks, and he'll try again. Gets it up ahead to Liam McKiernan. McKiernan comes down with some speed on the near side now. Liam McKiernan skates, stops, back at the blue line, leaves it for Reiske. Reiske skates in. Nice little move by Spencer Reiske. Reiske shot, saved by Dempsey. Kept in by McKiernan, and we're down to 10 seconds left to go. Esposito has it. Esposito with the shot, saved by Dempsey, kicks it into the corner. Puck is cleared into the slot. Nobody home, and that will do it. So a couple of good opportunities there for the Dons as we finish up the second period. Notre Dame will start the third period with a man advantage with 58 seconds left on the power play. After two periods of play, the score is the Marmion Academy Cadets, Notre Dame Dons, or excuse me, the Cadets 4, the Notre Dame Dons 2. You are watching Notre Dame Hockey on Facebook Live, powered by the Illinois Media School, and we will be back with third period action after this. We are back with third period action as the Dons trail the Marmion Academy Cadets 4-2. My name is Aaron Schellen, and started out very promising for the Dons as they got out to an early 2-0 lead. Liam McKiernan scored a goal on a 2-on-1, him and Jeremy Langbein. Langbein found McKiernan. McKiernan was able to roof it stick side high over Beckham Dempsey to give the Dons a 1-0 lead. McKiernan scored another goal about 6 or 7 minutes later on the power play, went the other top corner, beating Dempsey glove side to give the Dons a 2-0 lead. But since that point, it has been all Marmion as they have scored 4 unanswered goals, including 3 on the power play. And as we get ready to enter the third period, the Cadets lead 4-2. Notre Dame's got a prime opportunity here, though, to get back into this early as they are on the man advantage for the next 58 seconds as Andrew Galley is in the box for roughing. So see what happens here over the next 17 minutes as the Dons look to pick up their second win of the season, while Marmion is in a bit of a slump of their own as they've lost 6 of their last 7 games. They started the season 3-2. They're currently 4-8 on the season. So rough second half of their season after a good start. So we'll see what happens here in the last 17 seconds, or last 17 minutes of this game. Langbein, Esposito, McKiernan, Reiske, and Zorn is the power play for Notre Dame. Faceoff won by the Dons. Zorn plays across ice to Reiske. Reiske back on it into his own zone over to Andreas Zorn. Zorn back to Reiske. Fresh ice for this PK, for this penalty, our power play for the Dons. Scaled around, Langbein has it, deflects it back to Reiske at the point. Reiske plays it for McKiernan. McKiernan fakes the slap shot back to Zorn at the point. Shot goes high. Reiske has it, now tries to center it, and the puck is scaled the length of the ice. That will go all the way down on Miskovic, who has to make the save, plays it behind his net. Zorn loses an edge. Miskovic plays it up. Zorn is able to recover. Langbein skates out on it for Notre Dame. To Zorn in the center. Langbein has it behind the net. Wraparound attempt goes through the crease. And we have a whistle, and the net came off its moorings. We have 5 seconds left on the power play. Faceoff will come to the left of Beckham Dempsey. Notre Dame being outshot 29-17 here. 16:07 left to go in the game. Tommy Schrantz on the draw, wins it back to Izaguirre at the point, who just dumps it down in deep. Ryan Sheehan behind the net. Sheehan has it now on the far boards, back down behind the goal line. Bad angle shot, rebound, bad angle shot. And Dempsey's able to make a couple of saves, cover up, and that will do it for the penalty. Notre Dame is now 1-4-3 on the PK, or on the power play, rather. As I mentioned, Marmion has scored 3 goals on the power play tonight. They are 3 of 5, including a 5-on-3 goal to break the 2-2 tie. Puck is cleared in by Aaron Munson. He gets it back to Dylan Foster, though. Foster up ahead to Munson. Munson throws it into center ice. Munson gets it back. Wrist shot from the point goes high and wide. Cleared up and around. Sheehan has it. Tries to play it on the backhand out of the zone. He's not able to. That one clears the blue line. Notre Dame has it. Scotty Slechter on it. Loses the puck to Pichetti. Pichetti has it, goes on the backhand, throws it wide through the crease and wide. And Sheehan on it now for the Dons. Ryan Sheehan skates it into the Marmion zone, gets it down deep and goes after it. Down there with Greco and Sitar. Sheehan throws the body. Reiske's able to keep it in momentarily. It's deflected into the slot down towards goal. And is batted around there in the Marmion zone. Cadets rattle it around up off the high glass and out. Down on it comes Nowicki, forcing Miskovic to play the puck and gets it up ahead to Georges, who just dumps it down in deep. Sitar has it, clears it up and around, tries to get it around Leo Psycho. He can't, but then that puck is kept in by the Dons for a moment. Anthony Esposito plays it into the referee. Georges on it, loses it. It's cleared back up to the blue line, up and out by Aaron Munson. Reiske gets it cross ice to Gill. Gill up to Psycho. Psycho tries to play it, and he can't. Second opportunity, gets it in. Georges tries to play it, and Marmion takes over there. Galley gets it up ahead to Greco. Greco fires on Miskovic, and Miskovic is able to make the save. 13:48 left to go in the third period. The Dons trail 4-2. Pair of goals by Liam McKiernan so far are not enough, as Marmion has scored four unanswered goals to take this 4-2 lead. Faceoff comes to the right of Miskovic. Nowicki has it, thrown down deep, shot, score. They're going to wave it off as they're going to call a penalty on Marmion for slashing. So the goal does not count, or holding rather, excuse me. So break there for Notre Dame, as that was goal number five, but it was waved off as Marmion is going to be whistled for the penalty. It looks like Henry Walton's going to go to the bench for, or go to the box for holding, and Notre Dame with another opportunity here to get within a goal. 4-2 with 13:42 left to go. Faceoff's going to come just outside the Notre Dame zone. McKiernan, Esposito, Langbein, Reiske, and Zorn are out there for the Dons. Faceoff won, though, by Samuel Greco from Marmion, and he throws it down to Reiske, and Zorn blows an edge again. It's the second time Andreas Zorn has blown an edge here in the third period. Reiske skates out onto it, avoids the first defender, up into center ice across the Mount Prospect Ice Arena logo, down into the Marmion zone. It's poked away into the corner. Reiske's the first one on it, though. Taking the tour of the offensive zone, Reiske leaves it for Schrantz. Schrantz down low. Shot on, hits the side of the net. Puck is deflected wide. McKiernan tries to play it. Puck is kept in by Schrantz momentarily and then loses it. We're going to have a breakaway here by Samuel Greco. Greco comes down, tries to beat Miskovic. Five hole, and Miskovic is able to close it and make the save. Notre Dame just trying to get possession of the puck here on the power play. Schrantz plays it up into center ice, and Esposito skates onto it. Anthony Esposito's shot saved by Dempsey. Covers up, and we'll have a whistle with 53 seconds left on the power play. And we're going to have a whistle, and yep, they're going to call a delay of game penalty here on Liam McKiernan for firing the puck into the open net after the whistle. And that will negate the power play, as Liam McKiernan wanted that third goal. He just fired it in after the whistle. That doesn't count. So that negates the power play, and we will skate 4-on-4 for the next 52 seconds. And then Marmion will have a man advantage for a minute 8 after that. Faceoff won by Marmion. Puck cleared up ahead to Powers. Powers shot off the post. Cleared down deep where Nowicki has it. Nowicki stuffs it home, but they're going to wave it off, saying the net was off the moorings. So that's goal number two here in the last minute or so that's been waved off. See here, they're saying the net was knocked off the moorings before the puck went in. That was very close, according, looking at that replay. Notre Dame may have caught a break there. 4-on-4 for another 36 seconds. Faceoff won by the Dons. Izaguirre skates out with Sheehan, tries to go through Foster, loses the puck. Slechter plays it. He's hit hard against the glass, loses the puck, and Marmion comes down 2-on-2. Shot on Miskovic. Gloves that one down easily. 17 seconds left to go on the 4-on-4. And Marmion will have a man advantage after that. They are 3-for-5 here on the power play this evening. Faceoff's going to come to Miskovic's left. Puck battled for at the far dot. It's won there by Andrew Galley. Galley with the shot that goes wide, but it's going to be kept in at the point by Sitar. Sitar plays it right to Izaguirre. Izaguirre dumps it up ahead, 2-on-1. Izaguirre and Esposito. Izaguirre tries to center it to Esposito. Nice defensive play there by Sitar, and the puck is deflected up into the netting. And we will have a faceoff to the left of Beckham Dempsey, and Marmion is on the power play now for a minute two. 11:36 left to go in this one. Notre Dame trails it 4-2. Brady Gill has it at center ice. Puck is deflected down by Walton and cleared in by Powers. Powers throws it down in deep. Miskovic throws it to the near boards. Walton has it now. Walton on the half boards. Down deep to Powers. Miskovic makes the save. Powers is on it again. Powers skates in from the near boards. Wheels and fires. It goes wide off the back boards. Back behind the net to Galley. Galley tries to go cross ice to Walton. The puck is deflected and not cleared out. Kept in by Galley. Galley has the puck. Bad angle. Shouldered into the corner by Miskovic. Notre Dame tries to get the puck out, and this is what's happened on their last couple of power plays. They tried to get the puck out, had opportunities to get it out. They weren't able to, and Marmion made him pay. Galley has the puck behind the net. Galley back to Sitar at the point. Shot goes up into off the top of the glass. Powers has it behind the boards. Loses an edge, and Leo Psycho is on it for Notre Dame. Puck is skated out into center ice, but then lost by the Dons. Powers has it, or Powers goes after it. He loses it, and Leo Psycho is on it for Notre Dame. Psycho is able to get it down into the Marmion zone. Reiske hammers it down behind Dempsey. Walton on it for the Cadets. Skates right in front of his own goal. Past one defender, past two defenders, and Zorn goes down again. Walton with the backhand. Miskovic doesn't know where it is, but it's deflected and taken over by Notre Dame. Jeremy Langbein has it in center ice for the Dons. Skates it across the blue line. Goes down into the corner. Goes after it. Knocks the Marmion player down. Sheehan on it now. Sheehan throws it out front. Zorn with the deflection. Shot. Rebound. And Dempsey is up to the challenge with a couple of nice saves from point blank range. Pichetti has it. Throws it on Miskovic. Miskovic makes the save. So good opportunity there for Notre Dame as they had two point-blank opportunities in front of Beckham Dempsey off the stick of Andreas Zorn, and Andreas wasn't able to pot either goal. Andreas, the captain, with only 3 goals in 12 games this year. Faceoff's going to come to the left of Miskovic. Reiske clears the puck up and out into center ice. Evanoff goes down on it with Pacheco. It's cleared up to center ice. Reiske dumps it back in deep. We're down to 9 minutes left to go in the third period. Notre Dame still trails 4-2. Sheehan tries to play the puck, throws it, sweeping shot on goal, and Dempsey sticks that one up into the netting, and we will have a faceoff to Dempsey's left. Nice play by Ryan Sheehan there to steal the puck, kind of all in one motion, stole the puck, turned and swept it on the goaltender Dempsey, and Dempsey was forced to stick that one up into the net, creating a faceoff to his left. Sheehan, Schrantz, Evanoff, Gill, and Slechter out there for Notre Dame as they look to get within a goal here. Faceoff is won by Marmion. Brady Gill's able to keep it in momentarily. And then it's backhanded out. Schlechter has it, loses it, and Samuel Greco takes it, but he goes in offsides. Selector tried to play that one down with his glove. He just missed it. And fortunately for Notre Dame, Greco was in the zone before he brought the puck in, and that's offsides. So 8:46 left to go now. Faceoff just outside of the Notre Dame zone. Selector shaking his head, smiling a little bit at his failed attempt at catching the puck. Brady Gill has it over to Selector. Backhands it around to Chris Kawal, who's got his first shift of the game. Puck is deflected into the bench. We will have a faceoff. So Chris Kawal, extensive playing time with the JV club this year, getting some opportunity here on the varsity club. This is his 10th game of the season for varsity. Doesn't have a point yet, but has played pretty well for the JV club. We've seen the JV team a little bit more than we've seen the varsity club this year, and Kawal was one of their better performers on JV. See if that can translate here to varsity. Panico is able to keep the puck in momentarily. Kawal has it, throws it as far as the blue line, isn't able to get it in deep. Puck is skated out by Greco. Greco into the Notre Dame zone. Backhand, throws it on Miskovic. Nice play by Powers. He threw a little backhand pass through the defender, switched to the forehand, got there first, threw it on Miskovic, and Miskovic was up to the challenge. Miskovic has made 34 saves on 38 shot attempts for Notre Dame, so this is pretty par for the course for this Dons team. They tend to get outshot pretty regularly, and Miskovic does a really nice job in making sure that a lot of these games don't get out of hand. So icing is waved off. Back on it is Pichetti, up ahead to Aaron Munson. Reiske's able to keep it in, though. Evanoff has it down deep to Zorn. Zorn throws it to Langbein, and we're going to have a penalty called. No, the net's off the moorings again. That net down there to the right comes off the moorings at least 3 to 4 times a game. That happens without fail. So faceoff's going to come to the left of Beckham Dempsey. Zorn, Langbein, and Evanoff are out there for the Dons. We have not seen Liam McKiernan since he fired the puck into an open net after the whistle, so I wonder if coaching staff's trying to pass a message along to the young skater. Evanoff dumps it in deep. Zorn has it, throws it around the near side. Landvitt thinks about playing it for a second, but he doesn't. Langbein's able to clear it back down deep, and Zorn goes after it for the Dons. Zorn is down there with Heath Powers. He's pinned against the glass. The puck is cleared around, kept in by Landvitt. Landvitt from the point, shots deflected into the corner. Evanoff's the first one there. Langbein's checked into the corner, has it, tries to skate out of the corner, throws the body instead of taking the hit. Puck is thrown down on Dempsey, and Dempsey covers up. We will have a whistle. Jeremy Langbein saw the hit coming and instead of taking it, went forward and actually threw the body and knocked the Marmion player down rather than getting knocked down. But they're going to send him to the penalty box for that? Yeah, Jeremy Langbein's going to the box. 2 minutes for roughing here. 6:39 left to go. Notre Dame trails 4-2. I don't know about that one, but that's why I'm not wearing the stripes. Faceoff just outside of the Marmion zone. Cleared in by the Cadets. Up ahead to Walton. Walton skates it into the Notre Dame zone. Down behind Miskovic. Has the puck on his forehand. Back to the point to Sitar. Sitar plays it. He's alone at the point. Down low to Powers. To Galley. Galley has it. Selector puts the body into him. Scott Selector separates Sitar from the puck. Momentarily over to Walton. Walton skates around Esposito. Puck is deflected, is batted away nicely by Scott Selector, but cleared right back down in deep. It's centered there, and Selector misplays it, and Walton is able to take control of it for Marmion. Puck is cleared, centered, and pass is deflected. Greco tried to tip that one home, and he couldn't. Izagiri comes down with some speed now. Goes in onside, just throws it to open space. There's nobody there, and Marmion comes back down with it the other way. Samuel Greco through one player, through two players. Puck is cleared into the slot, and the Dons are able to clear that one as far as center ice, where Matthew Sitar will take over for Marmion. Played by Michael Greco. Greco leaves it for Sitar. 40 seconds left to go on the penalty to Jeremy Langbein. Sitar skates the puck into the Notre Dame zone. Selector puts the body into him, knocks him down. Powers has the puck tipped away by Izagiri. And we're going to have a penalty on... Who are they getting for this one? It might be, I think they're getting Scotty Selector with the hold of the stick here. That's Leo Psycho. 16 and 76. Getting Leo Psycho on the hook, so Notre Dame will be two men down here for 26 seconds. Marmion is now 3 for 6 on the power play tonight. Pichetti plays it. Miskovich comes out of his goal to play that one. Back to the point to Powers. Shot on by Blake Powers is blocked by Miskovich. Pichetti has it back to Powers, over to Powers. Keith Powers back to Blake. Blake cross ice, one timer goes wide. Puck cleared into the corner by Brady Gill. Blake Powers has it in the corner now, down to Pichetti. Pichetti behind the net, over to Munson. Munson to Pichetti. Blake Powers plays it in the corner. Pichetti has it now on the half boards. Back down deep behind the net where Nowicki plays it. And Notre Dame's able to fire that one down, and that will do it for the first of the two penalties. 5-on-4 now for another minute six. 4:08 left to go. Pichetti has it. He's hit into the boards there by Esposito. Esposito tries to play the puck out. He can't. It's batted away from Nowicki under the far boards. Selector has it. He has his legs taken out from under him. No call. Langbein on it now for Notre Dame. Comes down 1-on-4. Langbein tries to play it through onto Dempsey, and we're going to have a penalty called here on Marmion, I believe, as Langbein goes in. Yep, they're going to have a penalty called on Marmion for tripping as Langbein tried to get in on the goaltender Beckham Dempsey and was not able to, but... We're gonna skate 4-on-4 for another 41 seconds, and then Notre Dame will be a man up for about a minute 19 as they trail 4-2 here with 3:46 left to go in this one. Esposito out there with Georges, Selector, and Reiske. Again, no Liam McKiernan since he shot the puck into the open net after the whistle, so. My guess is we probably won't see him again the rest of the night. Anthony Esposito skates onto it for Notre Dame. Shot goes high and wide. Selector goes up onto it and then loses it. We got a 2-on-1. Galley and Greco over to Galley, and Galley beats Miskovich. 5 unanswered goals by Marmion. And with 3:18 left to go, it is 5-2 Cadets. Selector tried to pinch on that clearing play. Puck got away from him, sent Marmion away on a 2-on-1 and tape-to-tape passing. And 5-2 is the score. The ref's talking here as we get ready for the puck drop. 3:18 left to go in this one. One by the Dons. Landvitt has it up ahead to Sheehan. Sheehan plays it through Sitar into the near corner. Skates it around to the far corner over to Landvitt, to Reiske. The puck is deflected wide. Sheehan out front to Izagiri. Notre Dame's going to be a man up now for the next minute 10. Tommy Schrantz has it in the far corner. Andreas Zorn off the back of the net. Zorn leaves it for Lanvit. Lanvit throws it back to Zorn, but there's nobody home. Zorn's able to keep it in. Lanvit loses it, but then gets it right back. Shot goes high and wide, and that's going to go all the way around and out into center ice. Notre Dame skates onto it in their own zone, loses it to Galley. Galley throws it out front. Beautiful save on Greco by Miskovic. Puck is thrown out front. Notre Dame will take over there. Langbein skates out into center ice. Jeremy Langbein has it now in the Marmion zone. 26 seconds left on the Notre Dame power play. Has the puck batted away. Cleared up and not out. Langbein's able to keep it in there for the Dons momentarily. In the far corner, gets it cross ice to Zorn. Andreas Zorn shot from the point. Save by Beckham Dempsey. He covers up, and we are under 2 minutes left to go in this one. Down to 9 seconds left on the Notre Dame power play. The Dons are being outshot 42-29 here, and they trail 5-2 on the scoreboard. This one looked very promising early on as the Dons got out to a 2-0 lead on a pair of first period goals off the stick of Liam McKiernan, but the Dons couldn't maintain as the power play from Marmion absolutely killed the Dons today. 3 goals, 3 for 7 on the power play. They were 3 for their first 4. And Notre Dame, they let their emotions get the best of them a little bit. They went man down quite often, and Marmion was able to take advantage of it. Zorn has the puck now, loses it. Evanoff has it, gets it to Zorn. Zorn on the backhand, flips it up off the back glass. Langbein and Zorn behind the net, and the puck is covered up by Dempsey. 1:20 left to go. Again, our next broadcast will be next Sunday, starting at 5:40 for the varsity game, followed by junior varsity after that. So we got a double header for you next Sunday night. Faceoff coming to the right of goaltender Beckham Dempsey. 1:16 left to go. Marmion is able to clear the puck up and out. Brady Gill has it for the Dons. Flips it into the stands, and we will have a faceoff. Faceoff's going to come just outside the Notre Dame zone. One by Marmion. Brady Gill has it, though, and the puck is deflected over by the Notre Dame bench. Lanvit backhands it into his own bench, hits one of his coaches, and we will have another faceoff. There's exactly 1 minute left to go. So next Sunday, Notre Dame takes on St. Ignatius here at the Mount Prospect Ice Arena. St. Ignatius currently in second place in the CCHL with an 11-2-1-1 record. So very difficult challenge for this Notre Dame club starting next week. Got a whistle and... penalty on Notre Dame. Oh no, excuse me, face off outside of the zone. Hand pass, I think. Yeah, it was a hand pass. So faceoff will be outside the Notre Dame zone. 58 seconds left to go. Notre Dame's able to gain control of the puck for a moment. Lanvit clears it out into center ice. In the skates of Sitar, who plays it cross ice, up to Munson. Munson gets it up ahead. It's deflected wide of Tomas Nowicki, but it won't be icing because Notre Dame touched it last. Brady Gill lets it go through to Panico. Gill gets it back, skates it around a Marmion player, skates it through another Marmion player, backhands it into the zone. We're under 20 seconds left to go. And we got a whistle and a punch was thrown. And Lanvit looks like Jeremy Landvitz getting into it a little bit with a Marmion player, and we'll let the ref sort this one out with 16 seconds left to go. Refs have to do a little bit of sorting out here as we're going to have some people go to the locker room early. Jeremy Landvitt for Notre Dame will make his way to the locker room. So once again, our next broadcast, puck drop, is scheduled for 5:40 for the varsity game. Puck drop for JV will be around 7:20, give or take, as they take on St. Ignatius. So both varsity and junior varsity looking for their second victories of the season, as they both currently sit at 1-12-1 on the year. So difficult year on all accounts for this Notre Dame club, but some young talent, some players who are kind of thrust into the fire, so to speak, and getting that trial by fire, and they're struggling this year, but again, they've got some good talent. They've got some players who have played a lot more minutes than maybe the coaching staff would have liked, but you know, that's how they're learning, and hopefully brighter days are ahead for this Dons hockey team. The ref's still talking about how to sort all this out, but right now the only penalty that's up on the board is Jeremy Landvitt for 2 minutes. Not sure why they're sending players to the penalty box. There's 15 seconds left, and it's like Gill's going to go to the box, matching Miners, which is what started all of this. Matching Miners with Aaron Munson, as the two of them got into it, and then Landvitt came by and tripped a Marmion player, and he got the extra two. So Marmion will be on the power play for the rest of this ball game. Finally get ready to drop the puck here for the last 16 seconds of this one. Skated onto it by Galley. Galley skates in, shoots it on Miskovich. Miskovich makes the save. Miskovich makes another save. Sweeps it into the corner, but the whistle has been blown. So we're down to 5 seconds left in this one. Final faceoff will come to the left of goaltender Miskovich, and with the loss, Notre Dame will drop to 1-13-1 on the season. As Marmion looks to get one more opportunity here as time expires, and that will do it. So once again, here from the Mount Prospect Ice Arena, it started out very promising for Notre Dame as they got out to a 2-0 first period lead on a pair of goals off of the stick of Liam McKiernan, but 5 unanswered goals by Marmion Academy lead to a 5-2 loss. So once again, we will be back on the air next Sunday starting at 5:40 as the Dons take on St. Ignatius. So for my cameraman, Eric Willowhite, for my producer, Timmy Helms, my name is Aaron Schellen. And once again, the Dons fall to Marmion Academy 5-2. You have been watching Notre Dame Dons Hockey on Facebook Live, powered by the Illinois Media School. Everybody have a great night.